everyone in Python tutorial for beginner series. In this video tutorial, I will show you how if statements work. Okay, so first let me open this demo.python file which I have created. If you don't know how to create Python file, then just you need to go to file in the shell and just click new file and then just save this file at your specific location by giving some name. So you will be having this type of file, like my Python file name is demo.py. Okay, now let's see how if statements work. So for example, I want to check whether the given number is positive or not using if statement. So I prefer to ask the user to enter a number and I am converting it to an integer. Then I have saved in the variable called n. And now I am going to check given input number is positive or not with the help of if statement. Okay, so how you can write if statement? Just write if keyword and then the condition n greater than 0. After this, you need to give colon here. Because if you not give colon, you will get an error, invalid syntax. So after putting colon, Python will consider this is as a condition. And when I press enter after colon, I will be inside the if condition. You can see the indentation here. It means you are inside if condition. So always remember, when you write this type of code, you need to always provide an indentation here. Indentation means space or tab. If you don't provide this space or tab here, you will get a syntax error. Expected an indentation block. So always provide an indentation or just give a tab before your statement. So here I am checking if user enter a value and then that value n is greater than 0. What I am going to do is, I am going to print this message, enter number is positive. Okay, so this is complete if statement code. Now just save this program and run it. It will run in this shell and it asking the user to enter a number. If I enter a number 5 and press enter, it will give me the message, enter number is positive. Now if I run this program again and if I enter a number minus 3 and press enter, now nothing happened. Python is not displaying any message because here we are checking number is greater than 0 and here I have given a number minus 3 which is less than 0. So this condition is not satisfied. I am displaying the message for number which are greater than 0. So now what we need to do is we need to write the message for numbers which are less than 0. Okay, so here what I can do is I can just write else condition. And this else condition should start from here, no space, but we need to add colon after else and press enter. So the statement inside your else condition start after the indentation. Just write your statement here. So here in else part, I am printing a message, enter number is negative. Okay, just save this program again and run it. If I enter a number minus 3 and press enter, Python will give me the message, enter number is negative. Correct? So now as we are entering negative number minus 3, so it is checking the else condition. And in else condition, we are printing enter number is negative. So that's why Python is displaying enter number is negative if I type minus 3. Okay, so in this way, we can write if else statement. If this condition n greater than 0 is satisfied, then flow will go to inside the if condition. And Python will display this message. If this condition n greater than 0 is not satisfied, then flow will go to inside the else condition. And Python will display enter number is negative. Okay, and always remember that your code if statement or else statement don't have any space here. But the code which you write inside the if or else statement should have this kind of indentation here. Right? And it is not necessary that you can only give one line of code inside your if or else condition. You can give multiple lines of code inside your condition. So here in if condition, I am adding one more statement. You have entered a positive number. And here also in else condition, I am adding one more statement. You have entered a negative number. Okay, just save this program and run it again. If I enter a number minus 3 and press enter, it displays both the message. Entered number is negative and you have entered a negative number. Okay, now one more thing I want to discuss with you is that how to come out from this if else condition. How I can tell Python that this else condition is now closed or this if else condition is now over, so that your next code after if else condition should be execute. For example, I want to execute this statement. I am outside if else condition. If I write this statement just below this statement which comes under else condition, then this statement also will come under else condition. So how to write? What we have to do is there should not be any space before this statement. So this will be considered as different code and it will not include in if else condition. So now if I save this program and run it, here if I give 5 for example and press enter, now you can see it gives me 3 statements. So Python execute this code which comes under if statement, and then it executes another code which I want to execute after my if else condition. Okay, so it means if you want to write some other code after if else condition, you just start from no space. So I can say indentation play a very important role in Python. So in this way you can use if else statement in Python. So I hope you understand this concept. I hope you like this video. So please like, share and subscribe. Thank you.